Are you planning a wedding right now and wanting to know how to do it without hiring a DJ? Well, this video is for you. Three basic categories: music, schedule, equipment. Make sure to stick around to the end of the video because I have one major pro tip that's gonna help 95% of that stress get wiped away. I'm Andrew Kanakin and I'm a professional wedding DJ. This channel is made to help entertainers and those who have questions about entertainment. If you like videos like this, be sure to subscribe. All right, so for music, two words: Spotify Premium. Yes, you heard that right. Spotify Premium. Whether you have it already, maybe a friend or family member has it, or just buy it for your wedding day. It is extremely important, and here's why. You can customize your wedding playlist, look at other people's playlists, and pick and choose from that. With Premium, there are no ads between songs, so no random thing is gonna break in the middle of the dance. That would be horrendous. And the most important thing, I cannot stress this enough, if there's anything you're gonna take away from this whole video, it's this right here. You do not need internet or Wi-Fi or 3G, 4G, whatever it is. You do not need an internet connection. You have your playlist or playlists already ready. Then you can download the playlist on your phone, computer, whatever you want to play it with. So what do you need for the music? You're gonna need separate playlists depending what's all part of your wedding day. That could be a ceremony playlist, it could be a cocktail hour playlist, a dinner playlist, and then the dance playlist. Make sure to go to preferences on Spotify and set a crossfade. That means that in between the songs, it'll transition a lot smoother. That covers the basics of the music. If you want more explanation or how to make playlists, how to structure them, let me know down below. I'm happy to make that video for you. That leads us to the schedule. Yes, whether it's a more laid back wedding or you want it very structured, you need a schedule, especially when you have music being played. Who is the person or people in charge of the music on the wedding day? You're gonna want a detailed list of when you want everything to be played. So for example, the wedding party entrance, what time do you want it to start? How long do you want the song to play, etc. Another helpful tip is to make sure in these playlists, you actually have them in order of when they should happen. On the schedule as well, have who's setting it up, who's taking it down, when that's gonna happen as well, where is it gonna be stored? These are some of the questions you should be asking yourself. Finally, make sure the MCs or MC has this list handy as well, so everyone's on the same page. If there is anything that comes up day of the wedding, the MC, MCs, or whoever's in charge of the music, they can figure it out. It's your day to enjoy, trust that they got your back. Finally is the equipment. Get your pen and paper out, take notes on your phone, computer, whatever it is, you're gonna wanna write these down. You're gonna need two speakers, two speaker stands, a mixer, auxiliary cord that hooks up to the mixer. That could be a quarter inch connection or RCA, XLR cords and power cords for all the equipment. And lastly, a microphone. I would say use a wired microphone, a lot less can go wrong. If you're comfortable, you have some knowledge, you can get a wireless microphone as well. Just be sure to test it out, make sure there's no feedback and things like that. Bonus add-on, you can get lights too. This may sound a little overwhelming. How do I even set it up? Where do I get this stuff? Well, you can rent all this equipment. Google equipment rental store near you, DJ rentals, anything like that. A lot of these rental stores will actually explain how to set up all this equipment. You just gotta ask. This may sound a little overwhelming, and yes, the equipment part can be. So here is my pro tip. Thanks for sticking around this long. Hire a DJ company. Now, you might be thinking, Andrew, the whole point of this video is I don't have to hire a DJ. Yes, I get that, but hear me out. This is the best of both worlds. What you do is you actually contact a DJ company. They will set up and take down the equipment for you. What this does is you know the equipment's gonna be set up properly and it's gonna be set up on time and you don't have to worry about it whatsoever. This way for the numbers, the DJ will not be there. It's way cheaper. You're gonna be renting the equipment anyway, so just rent it from the DJs themselves. And you get to pick your own music still. Everybody wins. And a quick disclaimer, this is not a perfect substitute to have an actual live wedding DJ who has done dozens or hundreds of weddings. A live DJ, they read the crowd, they can troubleshoot things that go wrong. However, this is another option, and for many people, including yourself, they'll work fantastic. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, I really appreciate it. Have a great day, good luck on your wedding, congratulations! I'll see you in the next video.